All right.
Hey, do you remember anything?
Hold on.
I was in my classroom when,
Hold on, I got it. Okay.
I taught English.
Brian, I'm at one of your beacons.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one? This Nero radio has a GPS, doesn't it?
Yes, of course it does. Okay. You're at Olali Falls. Okay, good. Keep an eye out. A field op is going to be there any minute. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. O'Brien, come in. Your friends are here. O'Brien.
I told you, they're not my friends. Okay, hit it on foot.
Yeah, I know. What do you want me to do? Use one of these tracking devices.
Set up that rim. Not this time. I'm already tracking this one.
Okay, let's get this.
Follow the researcher. And she's there to investigate an infected subject. The freak that was tagged in a nearby cave.
A cave? You want me to follow armed Nero goons into a cave?
Just stay close to her. While you're in range, I can intercept her data.
Well, Brian...
I'm still working on the info you want. Don't ask.
Why the hell am I talking to you?
O'Brien out.
Squad check. I'm good. All good.
Yep. You sure we're locked down?
Doc, you're good to go.
Thought I saw something.
You must
be friends now,
we will open fire.
Hear that?
How you feeling?
Just stay close to her. Right over here.
I never got that.
Got what?
Easier said than done.
Stage one, stage two, stage three thing.
What do you mean?
I mean, the virus is what it is, right?
No, it's more complicated than that. Now let me...
Okay. I know I'm a grunt. Before the freak show, I was a biology major. Just give me the gist.
Really?
Try me.
Okay. We don't really know, but blood tests show. The current evidence suggests that the virus spreads through the lymph system, reproducing and attacking cells on a catastrophic scale.
Attacking?
Stay with
more precisely,
her.
Expressing a series of normally dormant proto-oncogenes into an active state.
Cancer?
Look at him. Look at all of them. That look like cancer to you?
Maybe you're really bad.
No. No, no, this is something far worse.
What do you mean?
This virus is on a mission. The freaks are what they are because the virus wants them that way.
What are you saying?
I'm saying... Jesus, what am I saying?
Terrorism? You're saying this was deliberate?
I don't know.
Is she done? Yeah, okay. Time to get the hell out of Dodge.
Thought I heard something. Stop,
okay, okay.
Or we'll shoot!
I'm leaving.
Thank you.
O'Brien. Come in. I've got the data.
Receiving it now. Thank you, Drifter.
What the hell is she talking about, O'Brien? About this virus, whatever the hell it is, or what it's doing? I want to know what the hell's going on, O'Brien. Why are they out here? What the fuck are you doing? O'Brien!
Okay. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
St. John, this is Lost Lake. Come in.
Yeah, Mike, this is Deke.
Heard you brought in Shane Riley, but when I went to the shack to question him, he wasn't there.
About that, Mike. I tried to bring him in. I really did, but he put up a hell of a fight. So he didn't leave me much choice, Mike. He didn't.
Open up. It's that Drifter.
Remember what I said about how we do things around here.
Yeah, Mike, I remember.
Lost Lake out.
First one.
Thanks, Ricky.
How's it work? Last day, it turned out.
Deke? Thinking about what you were saying about doing something to make a difference around here, pay back the camp.
I'm listening.
Do you got a few minutes? I want to show you something.
Yeah, guess I can spare you a minute or two.
So where are we heading?
You ever been up to the caves north of the lake?
I know. Come on, see if you can keep up.
Okay. Let's go.
I got marsh duty anyway this morning. Gotta see if any freaks are stuck in the muck out that way.
When's the last time you went up there?
Been a few years, I guess. When I was a boy, we used to live in that damn cave. My old man sort of fancied himself a geologist.
Sounds like we got a couple. Freaks stuck in the mud, I mean.
Yeah, sounds like it. Here, let me take care of him. Come
on. That's it.
Bounty.
Nice work. Schizo's just found a new man for the job.
You know what Schizo can go do.
Anyway, as I was saying,
we spent hours talking about how all these caves were formed when lava flows would harden on the outside, but the molten cores would still flow like buried rivers. You got the big caves that drew in the tourists, like Metolius up there. There's way more than that. Riddled all over these parts.
Okay, we're coming up on the highway. We gotta be quiet.
Jesus Christ! This is why you brought me out here? Smell a bunch of goddamn freaks?
Yeah. Okay. Come on.
Wait. Follow him. Where the hell are we going?
You'll see. Come on.
Now don't get too close. Stay down. What the hell are we doing, Deke? This doesn't seem all that smart, even for a goddamn drifter.
Hold up. You remember telling me about how the tourists used to flood up from California in the summer, choke off Highway 97 and the I-5 freeway?
Yeah. In July, folks smelled almost as bad as these here freaks.
Well, you weren't wrong about one thing. These freaks, the big groups, the ones that some call hordes, I think they're the reason we can't get their numbers down.
What do you mean?
Think about it, man. I've been out here in the shit collecting bounties for more than a year. Boozer 2, Ricky, Schizo, a few others. How many freaks you think I killed?
A few.
A few. Yeah, but their numbers never go down.
You got a point?
It's these hordes. Every night, there's a steady stream of them up and down the Sandium Highway. Thousands of freaks pouring into the Lost Lake Valley north of the Cascades.
And you think they're coming up from California? Highway's closed off. No one's been south of the Sandium Pass in years.
It's not closed off to the hordes. Freaks are the reason it's closed off. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make is that the hordes come in every night. Not a goddamn thing we can do to stop them.
You got that much right. Lost more than a few men trying to back in the day.
Yeah, I know. I was there. And every horde that comes through leaves a few stragglers or gets busted up and scatters. And just like that, freaks everywhere as far as the eye can see.
Yeah, you don't need to see them to know that they're around.
We figure out a way to stop the hordes coming through, maybe we can make some headway, reduce their numbers.
Make it safer. Free up more farmland, irrigation.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we do that? You know goddamn well you can't take on a whatever you call it, a horde?
This is how. I'll be goddamn.
Thinking that we...
Yep. Blow it the hell up. Stick it down to my there, there, and there. We'll bring down a mountain of rock. We seal this shit up.
Yeah, so we trap a few hundred inside. What good is that gonna do?
No, you don't get it. We seal this cave. Maybe they don't got no place to sleep. Or maybe this trail of piss and shit dries out, goes stale, and others stop coming.
Yeah. All right. You got my attention. Okay, come on, let's head back. All right, my knees are warmed up a bit. Let's see if you can keep up.
Yeah, okay. That's interesting. This.
Tell me, when does being out in the shit make you an expert on freaks? You spend your spare time just following them around, seeing what makes them tick?
Not exactly.
And how do you know about all this? About what a horde's gonna do, where they sleep?
A few days ago, I was riding north of Belknap Crater when a chopper flew by.
A chopper? What the hell?
Just listen to me. It was a black chopper. One of those Nero choppers that used to fly all over the goddamn place when the shit was going down.
And you saw one, still flying?
I followed him. I stole one of their radios. I've been trying to track him down, see if they have a base around here. Supplies. Shit, I mean, see if the feds are still alive, you know what I'm saying? They're out here doing field work of some kind on the freaks. They're studying them.
They got resources to do that while we're out here starving, fighting to stay alive.
I followed them up to the Grotto Caves. You know the ones?
Yeah.
They had motion sensors set up, measuring how many freaks used the cave during the day, and, Mike, it was thousands.
That right.
They said freaks all up and down the Cascade Range, south of Crater Lake, and north up to Smith Rock all use these lava tube caves to hibernate. So, we blow up those caves, maybe we have a few less to deal with.
Hey, this idea of yours, it's got some merit, but job like that, it's gonna take a fair amount of TNT.
He said you wanted help making Lost Lake safer. This is how we do it.
All right. Look, there's some things I gotta do, okay? But you meet me at the bridge in a couple of minutes. I know where we can find some.
St. John. You were supposed to be up at the farm an hour ago. My guy said he's got a shovel waiting for you.
Yeah, Schizo, about that, I'm busy. See, Iron Mike and I, we're just heading out on a run.
You and Iron Mike, you'll get your ass up that way today, or you and your gimp boyfriend are gonna find yourselves out in the shit. You hear me? Without a goddamn paddle.
Yeah, I'll get right on that. St. John out.
What do you want?
You got something to say about it?
Yeah?
You got a problem.
You're gonna have to trust me.
Okay, where are we going?
You know what they used to mine all around these parts?
Yeah, mercury or something.
That's right, cinnabar. They extracted mercury from cinnabar. Folks back east think it was gold mines out here and silver. Not so. Back in the early 1900s, cinnabar was worth more than gold. To operate the mine, you need TNT for expansion, blowing out new tunnels, clearing cave-ins, that sort of shit. And to own TNT, you had to register with the county, keep copies of the keys to all your lockboxes with the commissioner.
Wait, the county courthouse? Where the hell is that?
Thought you knew. It's in the old federal building.
The old federal building. The one in Sherman's camp. Jesus, Mike, what the hell? You told me, you told me that you were never setting foot in that place again.
Did I? I don't recall.
You were drunk right after Joe was killed.
Did I tell you why?
No.
Here, turn right here. This is it.
Mike, the place is going to be crawling. I don't think this is a good idea.
Weather holds, we'll be safe enough. All right. That there? It's the old federal building. That's where we're headed.
Let's not go looking for trouble. Stay out of the buildings. Come on. We got to head over this way.
Where are we headed?
Just follow me. He'll be on the commissioner.
And you know where he is? Where his body is?
Yeah, I think I do. You heard what happened here.
Yeah, everybody got wiped out, man, woman, and child. Only a few got out, and you were one of them, right?
Only two got out. Me and Nora. But it wasn't the freaks that took us out.
What do you mean?
Here.
Has called a truce. A meeting. Right here. Oh, we knew what was coming. We knew what was coming and we were prepared. Fight didn't last long. But it was bad.
They had ammunition left after all, and... Well, they... Oh, hell, you can see what they did. Like I said... Two people walked out of this town after all was said and done. And some days... I wish to hell one of them wasn't me. Commissioner's over there in the bean counter suit. Go get the key so we can get the hell out of here.
You didn't give a damn about sealing the caves. You brought me here because you brought me here because you wanted me to see this.
Not true. All right, you got the key. We're gonna go get the maps to those mines, just like I said, and we're gonna get more than enough TNT to seal every cave in the valley.
Bullshit.
You are right about one thing. I'm not sorry you've seen it.
Not following you, Mike.
I am talking about the war that's coming with the Rippers, the one that Schizo saw hot. Cares how many die on either side. Never mind. Come on, let's get this done.
Here's the door.
Place is locked up tight. Come on, gotta find a way upstairs.
Smells like something died in here.
Newts. Yeah, I smell them. Bad business. Okay. All right, this is it. Now we got maps to every mine in the county showing where they stored their dynamite. Okay, come on. Hear that? Yeah.
Weren't you expecting anyone?
Nope.
Do you have my back here?
Hey, I don't like starting trouble, but I'll finish it if I have to.
Stay behind me.
Hey, I could take care of myself.
I'm not saying you can't, but remember the last time that we were out in the shit.
Yeah, like I said, I'm staying behind you.
Who's out there? Something's going on.
Men coming!
Goddamn town down. Freeze.
Jesus, what a mess!
You know why no one goes into Sherman's camp.
Addie finds out you're out here risking your ass like this, she's gonna be pissed.
Now, how would she find out about something like that?
Not from me. About the Rippers, why you wanted me to see that shit?
No, Deke. I always saw a bit of myself in you, back in the day.
How's that?
You don't give a shit. All you care about your friend. Don't want to see him die, but me? Any other goddamn person on the planet, I don't think so.
Caring will just get you killed.
Yeah, that's right. Thing is, not caring will get you killed just as easy. Good folks of Sherman Camp did was stop caring about anyone but themselves and their own. Easy to kill a man when he's just some piece of meat standing between you and what you need. Schizo wants to kill Rippers because he don't think they're human anymore. They don't count. Standing in the way of what he wants. Well, I don't buy into that shit. I won't have it.
You know, Schizo, he wonders why I'm a pacifist. That's what he likes to call me. He thinks I'm gonna get everybody killed.
Well, are you, Mike? Are you gonna get everyone killed?
Freaks aren't gonna be around forever. Now, when they're... like Tucker or Copeland and his goddamn truthers. All right, but here's the thing, Deke. I'm not going out of my way to kill any of them. I've had my share of killing.
Even if Carlos comes for you?
My truce will hold. You can bet on that.
let me in.
Open the gate.
Well, Mike, I ain't gonna bet on that. Your truce ain't gonna hold. Yeah, for once, I agree with Schizo. The Rippers, they ain't human. Not anymore. What's up with you?
Why do you expect us to fix anything around here?
I'll be seeing you.
You're back. It's good to see you again.
Hey, Jazzy. How's my favorite bounty collector?
Yippers. Hey, stay sharp out there. I don't want to lose my best bounty hunter.
I wonder how Boozer's holding up. I guess I should go check on him. Hope he's awake.
Deacon St. John.
Hey, Damon. How's life?
Yeah, it is hard to find fuel out there. Hey, drop by next time. Might have something new in it. How's it going, man?
Hold on, I'll get the gate.
Deacon, hey.
Let me get the gate.
Deke, you gotta hurry.
Ricky, what's going on?
That guy we've been looking for, Eric Lynch. Murdered Camel and Reed at the farm.
Rich man, bitch. You know where he is?
Yes, he's on the north shore at the old boat launch. Schizo wanted to go after him, but Iron Mike said to get you.
I'll get to him.
Thanks, Deke. Hurry.
This is Tucker. You out there?
Tuck, yeah, I'm here, and I'm guessing you got another job for me. So, okay, I'll stop by. Deacon out.
Oh, shit, what the hell happened here? Well, might be worth having a look around. Yeah.
Hey, Deacon, can you stop by?
Oh, let me guess. You got a job for me. Yeah, okay. St. John out. Hey, I'll see if I can, make time. Deacon out.
Thank you.
here.
It's okay. Open up.
How's it going, brother?
No, Deke. I don't know about you, but I could use a hand.
You lay down.
Yes, ma'am.
You can't have visitors just yet, but I could really use a hand.
Okay, I'll see you later.
I'll be here. Hey, Doc, seriously, though. Will I be able to play piano after all this is over?
Very funny. William, lay down.
Okay. I could play chopsticks. No, seriously, I could. I'd be like...
As you can see, he's going to be just fine. His fever's completely gone.
Good, that's good. All right, well, I got to go take care
Deacon,
of some shit.
Like I said before, William really does owe you his life.
Boozer doesn't owe me shit. I owe him.
Hey, I saved two more. Eddie and Mia would have died without those antibiotics. I just thought you should know.
Seems like he's getting better.
Here for your bike?
Just looking for some stuff.
You go through a lot of this shit, yeah? Don't beat her up too bad. Okay. All right.
Deke, a group of men rode in, shot up the gate, and when we wouldn't let them in, they rode off.
Ah, shit. Which direction?
They headed west, but they didn't go far. They set up camp just north of Eden Hill. I think they might be planning another attack, so I need you to take a look.
Okay, right. Yeah, I'll handle it.
Thanks, Deke.
Open up. Don't get all day.
It's okay. Open up.
Deke, you there? I got out of the infirmary today, man. Addie said she'd heard enough of my whining to last her a lifetime.
Sounds like Addie. How's the arm?
You know, it's about 50% there. Sorry, a little amputee humor there. Seriously, though, it's like I can still feel my right hand, you know?
I think they call that phantom pain.
Yeah, that's what Addie said. It fucking sucks. In my finger joints, you know? Like, after a long ride, your hand gets gummed up. I go to flex it, and... Anyway, I gotta get going. Skizzle's got me on farm duty. I'm gonna see if I can pay off the damn pain meds that Addie has me on. Later.
Later.
Nice. Okay. You come here if you need anything.
St. John, I got a bounty job for you.
I'm listening.
You're looking for Ned Walker. Wears a red scarf. He and his crew came to the gate the other night. He wouldn't let him in. He killed one of my guards, then took off.
You have someone follow him?
He's holed up at a marauder camp just north of O'Leary Mountain. I think you know where that is.
No, but I'll find him.
Hey, Deke. How's life in the shit?
Jazzy, how's my girl?
Kid. Everyone called him Gopher. Never knew his real name.
Gopher. How old was he?
Like I said, a kid. 19, 20? No idea how he lasted this long. But he was a good kid. Why are you asking? If you spent more time at the camp, got to know folks, maybe you'd find a reason. Cope out.
Jesus! No! Stop!
Now I got you.
Thank you.
It's done.
You won't be hearing from that walker again.
Bring me his bandana. I want to see for myself.
Yeah, of course you do.
Open the gate. It's that drifter. Yeah, I know him. Teague, how's it going, man?
Hey, yeah, man. Show work.
Teague, how have you been?
Hey, Damon.
Hey, Deke. How's life in the shit?
Hey, Jazzy. How's life treating you?
Nice work.
Falling on my head.
Lost more than a few men trying to hunt down that son of a bitch.
Next time, just come to me.
You volunteering? Never thought I'd see the day.
My bike.
Go see Manny. If you got enough camp credits, he'll fix you right up. Deacon St. John.
Hey, Damon. How's life?
Hold on. I'll get it.
This should last you for a while. You don't want to run out of fuel in the shit. That's for sure. All right, check back. Later, man. See ya.
Hey, a deacon, right?
How's the bike business going, Zanny?
Let me have a look at it.
See you around.
Yeah?
Deke, thanks for stopping by.
What's going on?
Remember Larson? The guy who spotted that cow in Marion Forks? The one I told you about?
Yeah, I remember.
Well, he went back out there to see what else he could find. He hasn't come back. We think he's been taken by a group of drifters who've been moving through the Belknap Wilderness.
Shit, where was he last seen?
A building on the east side of town, the old wagon hotel.
Yeah, I know the one.
Thanks, Deke. I appreciate it.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey everyone, thanks for watching this episode, and as usual, leave a comment down below, subscribe for more video updates, and share this on your Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, and all the social medias. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and to turn on the notification bell to stay up to date on my YouTube channel. And if you guys want to help me out in some shape or form, I do have a Patreon account down below in the description box. And as usual, thank you for watching everybody, and have a pleasant day. Bye-bye.